Okay, so there's a lot of noise going on, but I can hear a little bit, so I'm gonna see if that works. That's so cool. Okay, cool. So I just stopped recording. So from what I know, I know there was a house finch, a hummingbird, and I think even a scrub jay. I've never seen a scrub jay in my house, but I think I heard one, so we'll see what the app says. Hear that? I think that was a hummingbird. Okay, so let's see. What? Alan's hummingbird. Oh my gosh. Okay, I think that was a scrub jay too, but that's so cool. Yes. Oh my god, okay. I know I heard a scrub jay too. Okay, so my understanding is that it only allows up to 3.47 seconds, and again, I might be wrong, or I don't know, hold on. Yeah, so I think that's the thing, because I recorded it for a while, and only this bit shows up, so I guess you just have to do it little by little. So I really like the BirdNET app. I was very impressed by it, and I live in the middle of LA where it's very noisy, and it was still able to analyze bird noises. Bird sounds, I should say. What I learned in my trial and error is that it only goes up to 3 to 4 seconds. So if you're recording for a whole minute, it's only going to capture those last 4 seconds. So for example, I thought I heard a scrub jay, which in the videos you can hear it, but because it's in the beginning of the video, it didn't capture it. It only captures the last 4 seconds. So if you're using it, just be aware that it only will analyze the last 4 seconds of what you're recording. Hello. White crowned sparrow. White crowned sparrow.
White Crowned Sparrow. Hello, White Crowned Sparrow.